Hi everyone, welcome to the ClassPoint channel. If you haven't already, don't forget to hit subscribe so that you can stay updated with all of the ClassPoint and EdTech videos that are released to help you in the classroom. Today's video is all about ClassPoint and Padlet, how they're similar, how they're different, and how they can be used together in the classroom. So obviously ClassPoint and Padlet are two different tools. ClassPoint is more used for interactive and engaging PowerPoint presentations, while Padlet is more of an online bulletin board for your students that can be used in a lot of different ways. So both of these two tools do have a lot of different features, so that helps you and your students not get bored of them. Plus, they can be used for any subject. So they're both pretty versatile, but they do have some differences. So first we're going to go through ClassPoint and give you the rundown on the best use cases for your classroom. Then we'll do the same thing with Padlet. And at the end, we're going to do a quick wrap up of how you can use them both together in the classroom. Like I mentioned before, ClassPoint is an interactive teaching add-in for PowerPoint that allows you to get instant feedback and ask your students different questions without ever having to leave your PowerPoint presentation. If you guys don't have ClassPoint yet, you can download it and install it for free at classpoint.io. And then once it's downloaded and installed, you will have an Ink and Note ClassPoint tab in the top ribbon of your PowerPoint. And from there, you can customize your different pens, you can add in some whiteboard backgrounds, along with adding in your five different interactive quiz question types. So ClassPoint is best used for synchronous learning, so whether that's online or in person, you can do them both. So we're going to run through a quick example here, and instead of going into full screen mode, I am going to go into our reading view so that you can see both the teacher side and the student side. So students just need to go to classpoint.app and then use this class code in the corner to join the class. So we can just type in this class code and click join. And once your students are in, they will be able to follow along with your teacher's slides. And when we get to a question, once the question button is clicked, the responses are open for students to submit. And multiple choice isn't the only question type. So there are a few different types, and we can go through a quick slide drawing example. So this one is pretty unique and a good way to really get a feel for how your students are understanding your lesson. So teachers are able to see the responses live on screen. We can close this, and in addition to question types, if you're annotating on your slides to describe and explain a question and you're running out of space, you can always add in a whiteboard slide. So this question doesn't really have a lot of space on the slide. So if we add in a blackboard, we can use a white pen and explain this a little bit more to our students. So that is what is pretty unique about ClassPoint, is you can do all these different things without ever having to leave your PowerPoint presentation. You're able to ask your students questions and then adapt your teaching depending on how they're doing and understanding your lesson in that moment. Now it's time to talk about Padlet. Like I had mentioned before, Padlet is this online bulletin board of sorts that allows you to create different Padlets. So every Padlet can be in a different format, and there's a whole bunch to choose from. If you guys need a quick tutorial on that, you can watch the video that's linked up above or down below. If you don't have your Padlet account yet, you can log in or sign up at padlet.com. Padlet is going to be best used for flipped learning or for some post-class work. So these are instances that you have a little bit more time to review your student responses. So we have two examples pulled up here, and this first one is for a flipped learning example. So we're going to have our students read through this article before class and then summarize three main points. Then I can look through all the summaries before class, and this will help guide me to know the pace of my lesson for when that day actually comes. So if students really have it down pat, then I can breeze through it a little bit easier. Our second Padlet example is for some group work. So this is for post-class when students have a little bit more time for discussion. So they can also do this individually, or you can have them in groups. This example is for students to identify different factors that influence birth rate and then how those factors have a relationship with each other. So students don't just have to use text to submit their answers. They can add in all of this variety of different data. So once they have their information set, this kind of acts as a mind mapping board for the students, and then they can connect the relationships to each other. When the students have more time, they can continue on that discussion from your class without taking up the time during your class. So that's a wrap on our ClassPoint and Padlet explanations. So ClassPoint, definitely best used for when you're in class and want instant feedback from your students right away, whereas Padlet, best used for before or after class when you have more time to review their responses. ClassPoint can be used all by itself during your presentations, where when you use Padlet, you'll also probably be using other applications. And one of those other applications can be ClassPoint. So you can have a pre-class assignment with Padlet and integrate it into your ClassPoint presentation and then continue that on with some post-class group work as well. If you guys have any other ideas on how you like to use ClassPoint and Padlet, please give us a comment below. We would love to hear it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up and don't forget to hit subscribe as well. Thanks for watching.